Just in 1 second, or maybe two, I'd like to give you some tips and tricks for myopic patients. All of you know them, probably, that we might have stuffy loma, okay? And usually you will take your camera, you see, okay, on the right corner, this image is not that good. I'll just take my camera to the right side and everything will be fine again, but it's not in stuffy loma, okay? So what you can do here is just change the direction of your scan like this, and then you will be able to see everything in one line again and have no blurry side of the OCT scan. What else can happen in myopic patients is this. There you have this really spheric shape, kind of, in this scan length you're using right now. And what you can do is to just avoid imaging this area, and you can just shorten your scan to get the focus on that information that matters for that patient in that moment without having it that tilted, okay? And how to do that, I just like to show you in the acquisition module where to find those important buttons. So I'd like to have a new examination. I'd like to have the retina acquisition continued. Okay. So again, my patient is just healthy. And therefore, I just brought you those pictures that you can imagine what it is good for. I'll activate the infrared and OCT imaging. And there we go. Okay. I'll illuminate my patient's eye again. And yes, where do you have to look at if you want to change direction of your scan? First of all, have a look right here next to this arch area. There you have the direction of the scan. Now it's set to 180 degree and you just can quickly change its direction up to 90 degree, okay? You remember, if it was tilted in one direction, in the worst case, it just switches to the other direction now. But what you can do then is grab the arrow of your scan in your infrared reference image and just turn this scan to the direction, and you're watching your OCT image, and hopefully it reaches one direction where it's really settled evenly, okay? And how to change the length of the scan? This is right in your graph corner right here. There you have the length of the scan, and you can just shorten it by pushing the minus sign, okay? And this can be done for each and every scan you can find here. You just can choose a preset scan and change it to your needs. And it's important to do that right from the beginning, that it is chosen as you liked it in all follow-up sessions.